All right, so we're going to show what a extensor pollicis longus tendon transfer is. So they took the tendon of the indices, right? Of the, because the index finger has two tendons, so it took that extra tendon and threaded it over and made it into the EPL, right? So this is, we're 4 weeks out. This is a crush injury, by the way. So he's had first surgery. You can see the lightness of the first surgeries, incisions right here. You can see where it's still adhered. Look at that, right? And then he's had second surgeries, one to release the carpal tunnel, do flexor tenolysis, just cleaned out all those tendons. And then they went back in, they took the index tendon and they wrapped it over, put it over here. This is 4 weeks, right? So go ahead and bend all your thumb all the way down. Right. There you go. Good. So part of it's just getting him to relax. Okay, relax your thumb. So the thumb moves at the CMC, the MP, and the IP. Right. So go ahead and bend all the way down. Right. So you see, look up here. You can see all the adhesions. Right. And then relax. Bend here. This knuckle. Nope, not this knuckle. This one. Okay, so I'm going to keep this straight. So if I want to isolate, I could wrap this one with a little tape and isolate it and just get MP. Can you get me a piece of tape? Okay, bend your thumb all the way down. So we can take a look at the flexion of the MP right there. All right, hold on a second. Wait, dame un segundo. It's all right. It's just for exercise. I don't need it to look pretty. All right, so I'm just going to tape down the IP. Was a little long, sorry. Making sure that doesn't move. So I'm gonna tape that down. Now bend this knuckle. Bend it, you feel it harder, right?
Yeah.
Are you, and now I'm isolating just here. Relax, relax. Relax your big knuckle. So you can bring your big knuckle down. Bring your big, this one, all the way down, all the way down. Relax, wait, hold on. We're gonna bring this down, right? We're gonna bring this down. There, you feel that differently? And then all the way up, 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 up. And we can work on some tendon excursion. So we can isolate, it's just that if this one moves, this flexor pollicis as long as it's gonna overpower and it's not gonna let us isolate. So we can do that as an exercise, just to get some motion in all joints. So it's a good way of, it's just a good way of blocking it and doing exercises independently. Go ahead, we want composite. Touch this one, touch this one, touch the next one, touch the next one. So close, look at that. Look at those muscles. You know how you tell when meat is like rare or well done? How do you like to eat your steak?
I'm sorry?
How do you like to eat your steak?
Medio, termino medio.
Medio, okay, so medio, you know, bueno. When you touch to this one, this one is soft, relax. It's supposed to be soft. You touch it, más suave. Ese músculo muy suave. You want medium well done, you have to touch all the way here. Touch. And then your muscle, toque muy duro, right? Mm-hmm. That's mm-hmm. There you go. That's well done. So you combine the love of therapy and eating. That's my job. You're like, where's my steak?
Where's my steak?
So we have a lot of scarring. So let me show you a little bit of scarring. So he had a lot of surgeries, but he had very tight intrinsics. And so they went and released the intrinsics right here. He's got ulnar nerve issues. So you can kind of see the clawing, right? Open your fingers, right? So he doesn't really go into hyperextension too much, but he does have some atrophy right here. But probably just because he couldn't make a fist. Go ahead and make a fist, full fist. So much better. It used to be really, really stuck in extension. So his most recent surgery was tendon transfer, and then he had capsulectomies. But this is what happens anytime you have any kind of surgery to the dorsum of the hand, the back of the hand, you have scar adhesions. Now, it's really hard to see the adhesions. You can feel them. If you really want to see him, instead of going this way, because we're always thinking about retrograde massage, right? Which is fine. If you want to work with scars, you have to go in the opposite direction. So I'm gonna go and push his scar scar distally. Go ahead and bring your finger up. No, up, up, up. You can see it, right? So if I relax, so when he's down, his tendon is going this way. When I have him put his finger up into extension, his tendon is gonna pull proximally, it's gonna pull toward his arm, and I'm gonna push in the opposite direction, which is distally. All right, go ahead, push up, and you can see it, right? You can see it, he can feel it. All right, do it with all the other ones. Push up, bring your fingers up, 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 and then relax. So this is, you're working on scar, up, and you can feel where the extensor tendons are really attached down to here. Bring it up, right? Relax. You can do it up here. Bring it up, 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 up. You can feel it, especially along here. So he had surgeries to release the intrinsic muscles. They were so tight, but of course that's going to affect his extension of the PIP. The best way to get PIP extension is MP flexion and IP extension. So this is one of the things that I do. When you're working on that, you've got to control the wrist. It's very important when you're working on the fingers and you don't pay attention to the wrist is going to start to naturally go into flexion. It's stronger, it's easier. So you've got to control so the wrist goes into extension. I'm gonna give you one of my tricks. Are you ready? It's gonna blow your mind. I control it using my pinky. So I'll put my pinky on one direction and I'll use my fingers and put it in the other direction, relax. And that way I always have control of the wrist. And that way when I'm working on a really stiff hand, I use two hands, right? These three control the metacarpal. The thumb control the proximal phalanx, and my pinky controls the wrist. So when they start to go in pain and they start pulling away or pulling down, I have control and I can move it. I've got control of you. Where's our music? Just because we're doing a video. No, I'm kidding. And then I can work and get some extension here. I can work on getting extension here. And I can work on getting extension in one place but flexion in another place. So that's my key thing. It also helps to save my hand. My hands don't have to work that hard, right? Miguel appreciates that because I give him extra love. He's like, no, yo no quiero extra. Yo no quiero.
Lo que quiero que sea mejor en la mano.
He just wants to get better, but he doesn't want the extra love because it kind of hurts, right? And then I can also work on flexion. Can work on extension, and flexion. And I can hold it and curl down, curl. Curl, 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 and push up, push, push. I'm trying to get isolated extension, right? Two hands now, two hands. Push up, 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 and then relax it, and up, 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 up. I can work on scar. I can work positioning. I've got real good hands on his, right? You feel like I've got you. It's not gonna fall anywhere. It's not gonna pull anywhere, and it's actually much easier on my hands. Hey therapy friends, it's Huang here. Thanks again for watching my video. And if you like videos like this that can help you just crush it in the hand therapy world as an occupational therapist, then hit the subscribe button and enjoy the video. Thanks again for watching.